Welcome back to Getting Started with Concur. Part 2 will cover the basic request and expense report. If you haven't completed Part 1, I suggest going back to that video for assistance with setting up your Concur profile. To quickly review, you can access Concur at travel.tennessee.edu. On the Concur homepage, we'll begin by clicking Request, selecting Create New, and then clicking on New Request. A new request has three sections to complete: Request Header, Segments, and Expenses. Please note you must have at least one segment or expense in order to submit a travel request. In the first section of the Request Header are fields that were required in IRIS. Please note that the trip name populates IRIS for budgeting and tracking, so your college or unit may have a naming convention. In the second section of the request header are some new questions. Will any part of this trip be outside the US? Will UT be paying for this trip? Are any students on this trip? Note that all required fields have a red mark on the left of the field. The third section of the request header contains the accounting information. This is the default responsible account for you in IRIS. If this is not the correct account, you can easily change it by using the drop-down menus that are provided. The last section of the request header is cash advance. This field is populated by the amounts in segments and expenses. We'll return to this section after we visited those tabs. Once you've completed all of the required fields in the request header, we can move on to the segments tab. Segments are used to record estimated expenses for airfare, car rental, and lodging. They are also used to record your full itinerary in the event that you plan to visit multiple destinations. To add a segment, click on the icon and complete the required information. Once you have completed the required information, click Save. Now we are ready to move on to the Expenses tab. The Expenses tab contains items that can be included in the cash advance. To add an item, select it from the right pane, complete the required information, and then click Save. Once you have added all of your segments and expenses, you can return to the Request Header tab to add a cash advance. Please note that a cash advance is not required. If you're using a travel card or simply don't need it, just skip this next step. To do this, simply click in the Cash Advance field, and it will automatically populate with 80% of the totals of your segments and expenses. Then you just need to add a justification for the advance. At this point, your request is ready to submit. If you're not ready to submit it, you can save it and come back to it at any time. You can also attach things such as conference information or a full itinerary. We're ready to submit, so click on Submit Request. A box appears asking if we really want the cash advance, and we do, so we'll click Accept and Submit. Congratulations, you've submitted a travel request. After you submit a travel request, you can go back to the request and check the approval flow. The approval flow will show who is required to approve your request, and it will also show when they approve the request. We're back at the Concur homepage to move on to the expense portion. If you have an approved request, it will show up here. However, we're going to begin with a new report. Start by clicking on Create New Report. Notice that the fields on this expense report are similar to the ones on the request side. If you have an in-state trip, you're not required to have a request in the system, so you would start with this method. Notice that there is one field at the bottom of this form that isn't required on the request side. This is for your meal per diems. If you plan to claim meal per diems, you'll want to mark yes here. Once you've completed this page, click Next. Because we started with a new expense report, we have to complete the itinerary. Enter the information for the first part of your trip and then click Save. Complete the information for the second part of your trip, and then click Save. Once you have completed your itinerary, click Next. Select your itinerary from the list, and then click Next. Here you are given the option to exclude meals that are provided. If a conference provides a lunch or a dinner, you can select them here. If meals are provided for the entire day, you can select Exclude All for the day. If all meals are provided for a trip, you can exclude all here. Once you've marked all of the excluded meals, click Create Expense. This will add your meal per diems to your expense report. Now you're ready to add other expenses. Note that there are no available expenses in this report. If you use a travel card, your expenses from your travel card will be imported into your account automatically and they will show up in available expenses. You can also create a new expense. This list is similar to the one that is provided in IRIS. Let's add a parking expense. Click on Parking. Once you've completed the required information for the expense, you can save the expense. Notice that we've been given an alert on this expense. We're directed to attach a receipt, and we'll do that momentarily. Perhaps you only want to claim half of that parking expense. Select the expense, and you can use itemizations to deduct half of the expense. Create itemization. So for expense type, we've selected non-reimbursable. We've entered the amount we want to deduct, and we're ready to save itemization. You will need to create another itemization for the other half of the expense. Here we'll choose parking. So expense type is parking, and the amount is the other $15. And we can save itemization. So now $15 will be reimbursed, and the other $15 has been marked as non-reimbursable or personal. Now we are ready to save the expense. Notice now that parking requested is $15. The other $15 has been deducted. We still need to add that parking receipt. There's several ways to do that. You can click on the red plus sign, or you can click on the expense itself and open it back up. To attach a receipt, click Attach Receipt Image. Attach a receipt, and you're ready to save your expense. If you need to add another receipt or detach this receipt, you could do so here. If you should need to adjust your itinerary or your meal per diems, you can do so by selecting Travel Allowance and Manage Travel Allowance. Here you can select the itinerary to adjust dates and times. To adjust the per diems, go to Expenses and Adjustments. Here you can select to exclude or include meals, and then select Update Expenses. When you're adding a new expense, and you select to create a new expense, such as lodging, then you realize that you meant to choose something different. You can change it using the drop-down here. Some expenses, such as lodging and car rental, require itemization. When you submit these expenses, you'll get an alert, and you can say yes, and it will take you straight to the itemization tab. Once you've added all expenses to your report, you're ready to submit it. Please note that a delegate cannot submit an expense report because of the terms and conditions. The traveler must submit it. Once you've read the terms and conditions, click Accept and Continue. A summary of your expenses will appear. Click on Submit Report. Congratulations, you've submitted an expense report. You've completed part 2 of the Concur Overview. Congratulations.